Washi tape is available in an array of colors and patterns, and in today's video I'm going to show you many creative ways to use it. I'll also show you how to alter commercial washi tape as well as make custom tapes in your choice of color and pattern. Here are a few examples of washi tape that I have in my collection, and as you can see there's lots of colors, there's lots of patterns, and there's even different widths. I've seen tapes that started as narrow as 3/8 of an inch to 5/8 of an inch, and there are even some, like what's in this package, that you get two sizes, and that's actually pretty common. We are Memory Keepers packages them this way, where you get two sizes of coordinating colors and patterns, and of course you have this really wide tape in here. So lots of different ways that this comes available. Now, washi tape is actually pretty forgiving stuff. You can work with it relatively easily. Lots of decorative uses, certainly some functional uses as well, because it's tape. It's pretty easy. You just find your end, peel it off. Now, you'll notice that washi tape tends to be just a little bit transparent, and that's pretty common, or translucent rather. That's pretty common across all of the tapes that I've used. It's super simple to use. You can tear it with your fingers, you can use scissors, you can use a cutter. I mean, there's all kinds of things you can do. You put it down and it's done. Now, the nice thing about washi tape is that it tends to be repositionable. So if I decide that this isn't really the look I was going for, it's pretty easy to pick this up, and as long as you're careful not to let it do what I did, which is to curl, most of the time you can simply, you know, push it back out and use it again. So lots of different things that you can do. Now, you can also color washi tape, which we're going to do in a little bit. You can cut washi tape to a specific width if what you have is a little bit wider than what you want. And we're going to look at lots of different ways to use it. Now, something that's really simple is like this album that I did a video on this last Christmas. And I folded up 12 by 12 paper and into these pocketed pages for this book, and decided that I thought that it needed a little bit of kick, and so I used washi tape. I applied half on one side, folded it over, and there's the half on the other side, and I used it sort of to trim along here. So there's just a whole bunch of different ways that you can use washi tape, and this is just the barest beginning. We're going to look at lots of different things next. The first thing that comes to mind, at least for me, when I think about washi tape is something really simple but I think very effective, which is to create a page or spread border like this. And obviously you can decide which colors, you can decide which pattern, and it's just a question of laying it out on the page. And then of course you can start to build off of your pattern, or just the fact that there's a border there, and you can do other things on the page as well. When I do this, I don't pay a lot of attention to pattern matching or anything else, really. I just sort of eyeball laying this so that it's kind of equidistant from the page edge as it goes all the way around, and you can see that I have one here in process. I've laid the first three sides out, and all I'm going to do now is come in and put the last piece in. Now, when I do this, especially when you're crossing the binding on a book like this, if you're not careful, you'll end up, and depending on how you position this, it might not tuck right into that area of the seam, kind of where the pages meet. And so I try to lay that piece in first, and I'm going to, again, this is repositionable, but you do have to be careful with it. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to lay this piece in right here first, and then I'm going to just gently tuck the washi tape into that fold and crease so that it sits in there real well, and it's not going to kind of stretch and bridge across that area. It's going to tuck in there nicely. I'll just come in and lay this across, and I'm going to let it cross that piece for now. And then I'll come over here, and I'm basically going to do the same thing. Just give this a tear. Now, you could miter these corners if you want. I have no desire to do that, but what I do is I use a ruler like this, and this is one of the Omnigrid rulers that's thick so that you can actually run a blade along the side of it. And I lay my ruler down, I align it with the washi tape on the long side of the page, and then I'm just going to very gently, with the tip of my X-Acto knife, I'm just going to very gently run it along this edge so I can trim this evenly. And I'm doing it very lightly, which is why you've seen me do it twice, and I'm going to leave the ruler in place, and then I'm going to start to lift this out, and that way, there, when it comes out, I don't actually have any problems. Now, that's not perfect, but again, in my world, it doesn't have to be. And again, I would repeat that process over here. I'm just going to line the ruler up with the long side here. I'm going to very lightly use my X-Acto blade, leaning it against that ruler. Cut, hold the blade in place. Now this is going to be just a little bit harder because I didn't leave myself anything to grab, but I can just lift it up with the blade, come in, take it right off, and I have nice square corners. Now there are going to be times when this maybe is a little bit too wide, and there certainly are ways that you can go ahead and accommodate needing a narrower width, and I'm going to show you that now. There's lots of different ways that you can cut this. It doesn't have to just be straight lines. Sometimes you get washi tapes sold as sets where you have coordinating colors and patterns but available in two widths, and that's what these two are. We're going to, in a moment, talk about how you can alter the width of washi tape sort of to get what you need. But to come back to borders for a second, a border doesn't necessarily have to create a border around an entire page or spread. You can use small pieces like this to create this sort of top and bottom border, as I've done here. And in addition to that, you can also put a border around an element or a group of elements on a page, like I've done here and like I've started to do here. And again, at this point, it's just, well, finding the end of the washi tape is always the challenging part, but it's just a question of eyeballing where you want your washi tape to be, and I don't mind that I'm kind of covering the bottom section of this heart, and I've covered a little bit up here. And then what I would do would be to lay these pieces out kind of like this. Again, I'm mostly just going to eyeball what I'm doing. I'm going to lay the tape in place till I'm satisfied with the way that it looks. And then I would come back in with my X-Acto knife and the ruler, and I would trim these off as you saw me do just a moment ago. And you don't need to see me do that again, but let me just sort of pat this down so it's not in the way. So borders can take many different forms. There's lots of different things that you can do here, but now let's come back to talking about, oops, washi tape that maybe is a little bit too wide for what you want to do. Now I know this is very tone on tone, but I think that you can see it. This again is our Aztec tile stencil, and the area between the elements that creates this grid is a little bit narrower than this washi tape, and so I was kind of mulling over what I could do to get this fit without it really overpowering the elements in the design. I wanted to accentuate the grid, but at the same time I didn't want to totally get away from what was in here. And so my solution was to cut it, and I could try cutting it with scissors, but my guess is that that would not be fun and it would probably not be terribly effective. So what I decided to do was bring out my handy dandy rotary cutter and my cutting mat. You can see that I've got a piece already started on here. Now, what I've done is, first thing you got to do, even though this mat doesn't look clean, it's not dirty per se, meaning that there's really nothing on here. I've already, but I'll do it again, I've already come in and I've wiped this off. Now for me, glitter is usually the bugbear in my studio because it seems to get everywhere. So once I know that this is clean, what you can do, again, always finding the end of the tape is the challenge. I know it's here. I just got to find it with my fingers. There it is. Use the marks on the grid, lay your washi tape down, and align it with the mark on the grid. And once you do that, you know that you've got it on there straight, and when you use the ruler, you're going to get a nice straight cut. So I've got this aligned. I'm going to come in with my ruler. Now I know that this tape, I believe this tape is, it is, it's 5/8 of an inch. And so half of that, if I convert eighths to sixteenths, 5/8 of an inch would become 10/16 of an inch, and so half of that would be 5/16, or a smidge over a quarter inch. Now this ruler is not marked in sixteenths, the smallest marking is eighths, so I know that a sixteenth is just half of an eighth, and I know the math messes with my head too, it's probably messing with yours, but if you sit down with paper and you figure this out, it will make sense. And so what I need to do here to get half of this is I need basically something that's a smidge more than a quarter of an inch, because a quarter would be 4/16 and I need 5/16. So I'm just basically going to line the edge of this up halfway between these two eighth inch marks. Again, the math is messing with my head, but I know this is what it has to be. I'll hold the ruler in place. I'll come in and cut, and then once I remove the tape from the cutting mat, again, the beauty of washi tape is that it's easily repositionable. I have this piece that I can now go ahead and use. And let me just put this here for 1 second, move the mat out of the way, bring the journal back in, and I'll show you what I mean. Let me grab this piece of washi tape now. And one of the reasons that it's really important to make certain that your cutting surface is clean is because obviously you don't want to put anything on the back of this tape that then is going to stop it from really adhering wherever else you want it to be. And so then it's really just a question of tearing off bits of tape, making certain that this doesn't get all wound up on itself. I'm just going to put that there for a second. And then you can come in and you can begin to lay out this grid however you want. Now, because of the way that this faded off, I probably don't want to do a whole lot more here, but you get the sense of the point here, which is that you can use your rotary cutter and you can cut some perfectly aligned narrow strips of washi tape. If I wanted to make narrower strips, I could do that too. Next, we're going to look at how to use the rotary cutter to make something other than straight cuts, and we can make some really interesting effects with our washi tape doing that. As I was working on projects for this video, it occurred to me that washi tape, because it's available in such a bunch of different colors and nice patterns, would probably make really cool stems on a flower. But as it comes off the roll, first of all, this is too wide for what I want to do, and it's pretty straight, and I don't know about you, but I don't have any straight flower stems in my garden, so I needed to do something with this. Solution is going to be to work on one of these self-healing cutting mats again that I've made certain is clean. There's no glitter going on here. I don't want to affect the tack on the back of the tape, and I'm going to use my rotary cutter. So I'm just going to break off a piece of tape, and I don't really care how I lay this on the cutting mat, rather. I'm not worried about straight cuts, and in fact, that's exactly what I don't want. So I'm going to use my rotary cutter, and I'm just going to come in, and I'm going to do some kind of curvy stuff along one end of the tape. And then I'm going to actually remove what I just cut, because it'll be easier for me to decide how I want to cut the other side once I can see what I've already got. So now that that's out of the way, I'll come back with the rotary cutter, and this time I'm going to do some more curvy kind of things, and maybe I'm going to narrow this down a little bit more. Again, I'll just lift this up and get it going. Can't get it. Okay, there we go. And again, you can see now I've got kind of this fun curvy shape going on. I think that makes a far nicer flower stem than something straight. And I think it was a little bit too wide the way it was either. Now the piece that I'm working on has an orange background, and this is pretty light, and it occurred to me again that this is probably not exactly what I wanted. And so I decided to go ahead and to add some color to it. So I'm going to take it off of my cutting mat. I'm going to move the mat for 1 second, and I'm going to put it on my nonstick craft surface, my nonstick craft sheet, rather. Let me get this mat out of the way. And in comes some distress paint. This was a good color for what I was doing, and the nice thing about the distress paint is that it's going to be permanent when it's dry. So I'm going to give it a shake, and I'm just going to lay some color on here. Now, put my hands on a piece of paper towel, and I'm going to come in, and before this gets a chance to really dry, I'm going to buff some of it off, because I don't want to obliterate the dot pattern that's on there. That's part of what I liked about this tape, but I do want to add a little bit more color. So this is such a thin coat that it's not going to take very long to dry. I mean, I could bring the heat tool in, but by the time I actually get it in here and get it going, it's just going to be a waste of time. So what I'm going to do is pick this up again. I'm just going to gently move it to one side. I'm going to bring my journal in so that you can see what I'm working on here and what I mean. And again, with this really bright orange background, the tape as it comes off the roll is just a little bit too light. Now, I've already got one in place here, and I've already got one of them, and I've already got my flowers in place. And rather than make them a full-fledged sticker, I deliberately left the edges up, and I just used a piece of score tape in the center to stick it there, and then I can lift to get my stem underneath, and I can lift too, if I could get my finger under there, just so that these are not flat on the page. I wanted a little bit of dimension, and I can do that by running my finger along there as I just did. So in comes my washi tape, and since this piece is long, I'll probably use it under the taller one here. Just get it started, make certain that this is kind of going in the direction that I want. I'll run it down the page, And yeah, I think that looks good. I'll just get that under there. Again, I'll come in with my X-Acto knife, and I kind of want this to end along the top edge of this border, so I'm going to just very lightly cut this with the X-Acto blade, just enough to cut the tape and not enough to cut the page. And off it comes, and there you go. Now, I'm not going to throw this piece away because I want to make some leaves for my stems. So again, I'm going to move this out of the way, and I'm going to bring my cutting mat back in. I could probably do this with scissors, but I think it's way easier to just do it with an X-Acto knife. And I'm just going to cut some leaf shapes. Nothing fancy, just some little shapes that suggest a leaf to the viewer's eye. Again, I'll lift off what I cut away, and there you see the leaves that are left. So let me just get rid of this, pick these guys up with the end of my blade, put them to one side on my nonstick craft sheet. And out this goes, and back in comes the journal. Okay. And so I can just go ahead and I can add some leaves here. Again, this is a very whimsical, non-realistic style, and I really like it. And so just little simple shapes like this really work. So washi tape is good for many, many things, and don't think that you have to be stuck with it sort of as it comes off the roll. You can change the color and you can change the shape. This page spread pretty much takes the things that we've been doing and combines them all into one. We have page borders, we have areas separated off from the borders that become their own little grid, if you will, and this washi tape has been colored to change its appearance. As it comes from the roll, it looks like this. It's very white, and it was not at all in keeping with this spread. What I kind of imagined was, and I can't think of what the books are called, but you see them, they're books about natural history. They have plates, and on them you might see an assortment of insects that are marked, you know, figure 1 through 5 or whatever. Sometimes you see floral images, and it describes what the botanical name for the flower is. And that was really what I wanted to achieve here. I'm using insects, and this is from our insects collage sheet, and you can kind of see what's left here. I've put score tape on the back and cut them out so that they'll be self-adhesive, and once I get these and I decide on where they want to go, I'll stick them down, and then I'll probably come in with a white jelly roll pen, and I'll just make notations on here that further serves to make this look like a page from one of those botanical books. But I thought it would be fun to show you because, again, I've cut the tape down to make it smaller. I've added color to dramatically change its appearance. So I want you to think about lots of different things and all of the ways that you can use washi tape, both as it comes off the roll and if you decide to go ahead and change it. Now, the one other thing that I do want to talk about before we jump into making your own washi tape is how you can use washi tape functionally. And by that I mean as tape to adhere something. And we'll come back to this very first spread that we looked at. What I have in mind for this, oops, is this little guy. This is one of the Stampatique originals. This is called Hug Monster. No, I'm sorry, it's not Hug Monster, it's Whisker Monster. And he has this little sign. And what I did was I used some of my small stamps after I colored him and put, of course, some glitter on him to just put a message in here. And I kind of envisioned this on the page, but rather than cutting it out and making a sticker like I showed you a moment ago with the insects, I thought it would be cool to use the washi tape as tape. Now, I'm not going to bother to cut this with scissors, and I probably cut this a little bit too big, but I can refine this later. But what you do is you just literally tape something down with it, and you can, you know, tape 2 edges, you can tape 4 edges, there's lots of different things that you can do, but obviously washi tape is adhesive enough that you can use it as tape. Now, if you wanted something a little bit more permanent, it might make some sense to put some glue down underneath the washi tape. Because this is repositionable, you are going to be able to pick it up, and so for it to be truly effective as tape, you probably do need to help the adhesive along a little bit. But again, there's just so many fun ways that you can use this stuff that I have all these ideas sort of burbling around in my head, and I'm sure that you are going to as well. sometimes no matter how hard you look, you just end up not finding exactly what it is you're looking for. And then the solution becomes to make your own, at least in the case of washi tape. I have half-inch score tape here, and you can see a finished piece. And I've laid some score tape out on my table, and let me show you how easy it is to customize this to make whatever you want. Now, I'm working with white tissue paper, but you can certainly work with any color tissue paper. This process is exactly the same. So you lay your score tape on your table with the sticky side up. Go ahead and put the tissue paper on top of it, and then you want to cut this out. Now, if you kind of run your scissors along the edge of the score tape, that backing will act as a guide so that you can get a nice, even cut. Okay, so there's our score tape. Started. It will soon look like this. I'm going to work with these same colors again. It's a combination of my diluted versions of fresh lime, some stream, I'm going to need a piece of paper towel too, and maybe a little bit of London blue if I want to darken this up a little bit. I'm just going to dab this away. Now the nice thing about score tape is that even though it's tape, and there's adhesive on there, and as you know, adhesive can sometimes activate or react to heat. I want this a little bit darker, so I'm just going to mess while I'm talking. You can actually heat it to dry it. The tape might curl a little bit, but it will not affect the final outcome. It will not affect the adhesive enough to the point where it won't work. All right, so that's kind of looking good, and it wouldn't be a video from Joggles and Barb if I didn't add some glimmer to it. So I'm just going to put in a little bit of my Perfect Pearls Mists, so that I get some glimmer when this is done. And then I'm just going to bring in my heat tool and dry this off. The score tape did bend a little bit, not a problem, just flatten it back out. And I really like this color. So now to get a message on there, and that's really my goal, I like to be able to put messages on score tape like this. It sort of lets you customize and say whatever you want. And you can write it on a page, but it can be fun to do it this way as well. And you can do little short pieces with just a single word. You can get as wordy as you want. And so what I'm going to do now is come in, and I just happen to have archival, stays on will work. I want something that's permanent like this. And so I'm just going to go ahead and put a sentiment on here. Now I've chosen to do the word laugh, and you can see I didn't get good coverage right there. I'm going to show you how to fix that. I chose to do the word laugh in all uppercase letters, and then I have the word a lot, or actually it's two words, it's a and then lot, and I'm going to do those in lowercase letters just for a little bit different look. And I never worry about how straight or not, and mostly it's not, my letters are. I kind of like that look where it's not perfect. And so now it says laugh a lot. I didn't get good coverage on the H, and I didn't finish that circle on the O, so I'm going to come in with a Pitt pen, and I find that these work really well. I'm just going to ever so gently fix that, and I can come in here and kind of fix where the letter didn't properly get filled in, and just create the edge there, and then I have it, and I'll just give this a tear and go ahead and position it on my page. And like I said, you can pretty much put any sentiment on here you want. When you work with white tissue paper, you can go ahead and create any kind of color that you want. And of course, as you know, when you get a package from us, it's always got some kind of colored tissue paper inside, and that's perfect fodder for this kind of stuff as well. We've looked at lots of different ways to use, create, and work with washi tape today, whether you use it straight off the roll, whether you cut it, whether you color it, or whether you make your own as we just did here. I hope that you enjoy working with it, and of course that you make art and have fun.